Hello YouTube, welcome back to PIRAS Motorsport. Today we're going to be talking of the GR Corolla engine airbox intake by us, PIRAS Motorsport. So before we get going, please make sure that you like the video and that you leave any comments after seeing this, because I would really like to know what you're thinking in regards to our work. So it's been a very difficult couple of months with the launch of the GR Yaris airbox, and then once again the update on the V2. So we've been super busy through it all. And in the meantime, the second team has been working on the GR Corolla, always under my coordination. So I really have to thank Block Motorsports up in Poland, because they have a GR Corolla and they've been really helpful. A lot of analysis, a lot of counter measurements and scans and everything. And in this specific car, I wanted to be sure, and we are using scans from four different places around the world, including this in Poland. And also, before coming to market with anything, just like we did before in the GR Yaris, but even to a greater extent, we're going to test everything on the car and make sure that everything is perfect, not only fitment-wise, but also mechanically. And then we will go into actual production and test fit the production parts again, because if there could be any problems, we'll just narrow them out. And only after that, we will give this to the market and put it on sale. So just as you know. So the video today is to show you what this actually looks like. So pardon me if I look at my monitor, but I want to look at the pictures together with you and show you what we've been working on. So this is basically a kit made of five major parts. So we have the map holder, we have the rear section of the airbox, we have the middle section of the airbox, and we have the front section. This is another view, and a lateral view, just to give you an idea of how the parts go together. And yes, it has not been an easy task to put this together and to do it in a way that won't move and that will stay in the car for all the time is necessary. So more specific, the front duct that goes, let's say, in front of the radiator next to the, let's say, driver's side headlamp is something that we went crazy working on, because there is very little space and still we had to guarantee enough airflow. And in the end, we managed to pair it with the main duct in a good way and to have sufficient space. And it's all going to be fitted with the plastic buttons, just like on the standard car. So take in, take out, not a problem. And it's going to bring all the performance that is needed. Some of you have left me comments about, for example, making a double intake duct in the front, and we looked into it, but from our point of view, in the added work and cost that was needed to produce something like that, and making a double duct in a way that would not affect the laminar airflow would have been huge. So already there are tariffs now, you know, over about 25% to USA. And, you know, we want to bring to market products that are really good, but are competitive in pricing. And this solution works well enough to up to around 500 horsepower, once again, just like the GR Yaris. So we don't really see a need to do anything different. Also, because who's going to be going with even larger horsepowers is probably going to go with a very modified car and then just an open filter and be using it mostly to drag. So this is not the application. We are aiming to street cars, track day cars, and all of that that can be used every day and get the enclosed performance that you need. So this is a view of how you can see the airbox kit fits inside the engine bay. And yeah, this is from where the air comes in on the left, from in front of the bumper. And you see that While the design looks very strange if compared to looking at it from the front duct actually maintains mostly an equal section. And this is why we had to open it and close it in Z, in the other direction, in order to make sure that we had the clearance we needed in the various components, but in the same time we were guaranteeing and warranting all the same airflow. So I'm happy of this design. And this is how it sits once more within the scan of the car. And you can see there from the OEM snorkel that we are exactly in place. And once more here, it's how it feels. So the fact is that this duct was so big and so much bigger than the OEM snorkel to get all this power through, and you know, with a lot of headroom, that we had to invent something new for the radiator cover. So once we did that, we decided that we had to also ship this product all over the world, because your Corollas are not even sold in Europe. And yeah, there are a few, but it's very rare. So we decided to keep the box sizes smaller, to divide it in two parts. And dividing it in two parts, the main question we had was how to make that the two parts then in your garage or at your mechanics can be fixed together in a way that will not create problems through time. So this is the conjunction and is the union between the two parts, and we're using crush bolts. And these crush bolts, you can then, you won't be needing to open it and close it many times. Once it's closed, you see it, but you can do so every time you wish and your heart is content. But once the first installation is done, the whole assembly of the radiator cover will just come in and out without any problems as a whole. And this is the full unit. And as promised, the breakdown of the parts. As you can see, on the right-hand side of this image, we are already seeing the V2 MAF sensor holder, mass airflow sensor holder, and also the updated rear part of the duct. And this is what you're going to get in the Corolla, just like from now on in, everybody's getting on the Yaris. And just today, I got a new data set from my colleagues in Profit Tuning. And the data set is like a one-to-one match, perfect on the OEM GIRS MAF readings. So it's just perfect. The difference is, and I'm going to make another video on this, but just a little spoiler teaser, is that in order to get the same flow and the same pressure from the turbo of the OEM intake with our intake, you have to reduce the wastegate duty cycle by, depending on the points on the curves, 7 or 8%. That is how much more this airbox we do flows. So it's huge. I'm really, really happy of the results. So nothing more on this today. Just about the timings. So next week, we are going to mill the molds. And the following week, we are going to make a couple of prototypes. These prototypes are going to go up to Block Motorsport. They're going to test fit them in the car. If everything is fine from there, we will move forward and make a first ramp up of production, retest it again. In the meantime, we'll do all the electronics testing and the ECU testing. But, you know, the difficult part was a MAF holder, but just to be sure that we get the flows we want and the way we've planned it. And I believe that in the month of October, we're going to have this to market. So this time I'm not going to do pre-sale orders, because I want to be sure that everything is perfect. So I want to give us the time, if it's a week or two more or less, whatever it takes to be sure about things. And then it's going to come to market. And my oh my, there's going to be nothing like this in this price point. And performance-wise, in total, I think this is going to be the best unit out there. So thank you very much for supporting me, for your nice comments, and I'm going to see you next week. Cheers now.